Welcome to Quick Bites, the lunchtime live stream with your tech integration specialist, Scott Conway. Welcome and thank you for joining us today. If you're joining us live, please take note of the URL at the top of the slide you're looking at. That is where you can ask a question during this presentation, and we will attempt to answer as many questions as possible by the time we're done. This is a short session, about 10 to 15 minutes in length, and you can also watch this after the fact, as I will be recording this and playing it back for you via my YouTube channel. So I want to get into today's topic, which is a staff communication tool called Google Hangouts or Google Chat. I do want to preface this with, this is only a tool for staff. As right now in our organization, this is only enabled for adults. The students do not have this tool available to them, so it will not work in our organization for you to communicate to a student or to a student account in this manner. So that will not function. This really is meant to be a staff-to-staff, potentially staff-to-parent phone communication tool, which I'll talk about when I get into this. But again, in our organization, this functionality is disabled for student accounts, so it will not work. Now, if you're in some other organization, you would have to check with your organizational admin to discover whether or not it is on or off and for who it, which it is on and off. So let's get right into this. The nice little tool that I want to show you first is right within Gmail, actually. And this is the chat feature, the Google Hangouts chat feature. And my counterpart and I use this quite often, even though we're sometimes just one desk away. And I do use this with a few other staff members who it's just a lot easier than picking up the phone to just almost text message them. That's really all that this is. It's kind of what Instant Messenger used to be. It still kind of is out there and exists. And it's called Google Hangouts Chat. And it lives in the lower left-hand corner of Gmail. So if your inbox is opened and set aside, you can quickly come in and you can see I have my counterpart, Tom Leewak, here. I can click on it. And it will open in a little box over here to the right, which I can expand if I'd like. If I don't have the person already here in the left-hand side, I could also just create a new conversation by clicking the plus symbol next to my name. And you can see the little green dot next to my name means that I'm online. Now, Tom would have one if he was online as well right now. So it just means that his Gmail is probably closed. But if he was on, it would also signify with a green dot that he was on and active. And you could see he was active up here 2 hours ago. Now, I've got a couple options. Right away, this is just instant messaging. So I could type a message right here and hit enter, and it would send him that notification or that instant text. Now, he might get this in multiple different ways. He might get the notification on his mobile device because he has Google Hangouts, the mobile app, installed on his mobile device. He might get the notification there, and he might reply right from there. He might also be just opening up his laptop or his computer and notice as he logs into Gmail that the notification has popped up and he might answer from there. So he's got two places he can answer from. And it's just a simple text message. It's an instant message. I can also add emojis and stickers. You can see I have that option here. I can also insert or attach a photo. So if I'm trying to explain something or show something to my colleague, I can insert a photo. Now, if I'd like, I could actually also launch a full-fledged phone call from here. And this uses the Hangouts dialer function, which I'm going to show you in the Hangouts standalone tool momentarily. But I could also use voice over internet protocol, VoIP, as you see it, to talk to this person like I was talking to him on a regular phone. And that would be through the phone call. Now, I also have, in addition to that, a video call. If I click on this little video call, it will open up a video session. I can enable my microphone. I can enable my camera. I could disable my microphone and disable my camera. I don't know why I would do the microphone, but if I don't want my counterpart to see me, I could ultimately disable the camera and just talk through the voice over internet protocol. It's really not much different at that point than the phone call, but we can initiate a video call right from here as well. This is using the same platform as Google Meet, but please be aware that Google Hangouts is the consumer-facing product. So that's why earlier I mentioned that you can actually interface with parents via this tool, because anyone with a Gmail account could potentially open a Hangout with you, even though you're in an organization. Google Meet, on the other hand, is the organizational tool that would only work within the organization. So Google Hangouts is the consumer side, and we'll show you a little bit of that in a minute. But I just wanted to orient you to the little Google Chat, because some of you might be able to do away with just this. It's a quick way to send a quick message back and forth. And again, if you have the Google Hangouts mobile app, you'll be able to kind of send and receive these little quick instant messages from your phone too. So it will carry over across multiple devices. You do have some notification settings and things in here. You could turn notifications on, you could turn it off. Same thing with the conversation history. We can archive this conversation. We can flat out delete the conversation. And if you do happen to get someone who's annoying and won't let you work and won't leave you alone, you could always just block that person. But then you'd have to, if you ever want to continue a conversation, you'd have to unblock them. So this block tool is really for someone who you need to eliminate altogether. Just get rid of them off of the Google Hangouts area. So that is the Google Hangouts chat function right in Gmail. It's perfect for your workflow throughout the day as an alternative to email. It's just a quick little instant message, almost as if you were using a text messenger, but it is account to account, staff to staff in district. Now I'm going to also open up the Hangouts tool, and I'll talk a little bit about this. Again, this is Google Hangouts. You can see that where we picked right up where we left off, there's my counterpart Tom, and the message that I had with him, the chat opens up right here. So it's a one-to-one. This is now the full-fledged standalone service, Google Hangouts. And you can see I have the same options. I have a conversation, I can do phone calls, I could also really kind of utilize the whole video message function here too. And that's not showing in the left-hand navigation, but it is right here in the center. So I can do a video call, a phone call, or a message. And I have all of those options. So this is kind of the full-fledged platform. But again, if you're in Gmail, it is also located in the lower left-hand corner. So what happens here, and I'm gonna close this out, if you were to create a phone call, you can see that I can actually just dial a phone number directly from this platform. Now, the phone number by which it gives you or assigns you is often based on your internet service provider. So from where I'm located right now using the Comcast service, it's quite possible that when I dial out from this service, that the incoming phone number might look like it's from Hartford, it could look like it's from Boston, it could be from New York. So just be aware that if you use this phone call tool and you dial out to a third party, and you could see the Hangouts dialer over here, allows you to call phones. You can install this. This actually would work best from your mobile device. We'll let you call someone, but it will display on the other end as if you're calling from a different location. So that might be a little confusing to whoever you're calling from that's outside the organization. So just maybe preempt that parent or whoever you're calling with, listen, I'm gonna be calling in, but it's not gonna show. I'm gonna call at this time and maybe set it up and prearrange it ahead of time. The video call will work as well. Again, adults inside our organization are able to use this functionality, but the Google Hangouts tool will not function for students in our system. And that's our organizational settings. So this is a great little tool. Like I said, instant messaging, chat back and forth. You can also do a phone call from this. You can do a video call, and you are able to create, I'm going to test this out right now. And I'm going to just dial in a number that I know of and no one will answer. It's going to go straight to voicemail, or at least it should. And you can see that it's calling over here in the panel. I don't know if you can necessarily hear anything, but this is going to call through and it should answer and go to a voicemail. I'm just going to let this kind of go through to verify that it is currently working. Okay, so it did. I'm not sure if you can hear that, but it did go through to voicemail and it said that this person's not available. Please go ahead and leave a voicemail. So that number, again, on the receiving end might look like it's coming from New York City or New York or Boston or Hartford. And that is most likely dependent on the internet service provider for which you use. I did try this out with another staff member a couple days ago, and she was using it to be able to call a parent. The phone number we tried, we called back the next day and it did work. So it does look like that it solidifies the number for you, whatever number you are as you call out. It does continue to work day by day. It just does not allow you to preset your phone number. So you can't choose your phone number in this regard. It's kind of chosen for you by the Google Hangouts caller. So just another option, something you could utilize if you don't want to call from your own phone. You can use this Google Hangouts phone caller, and that will allow you to call a parent possibly. On a side note, if you do want to use your cell phone or your home phone, all you need to do, and I put this on the staff portal, is type the *67, press *67 in the person's phone number, and you will be able to block your phone number from going through. So it basically comes through as private caller or anonymous or no number. There's a couple different ways. It depends on your service, but it will come through without your phone number. So again, if you want to mask your cell phone number or your home phone number, *67 and then the person's phone number, and it will come through as anonymous. It's just a one time, every time you go to use it, it's a one time use, but it will work. There is no solution for masking your text message. So that functionality does not exist. This *67 only works on an actual phone call from a cell phone or a landline. I do have one question. It looks like it's coming through. When I use Google Chat, it will show up on the computer screen as well as the phone. Yes, yeah, so if you do have the mobile phone app installed, it is possible that you'll see the chat come through on the mobile device as well as the desktop computer, either through Google Hangouts like you saw with Tom and I here. You'll also see it down here on Gmail. So it does cross over from the Gmail insert in the lower left corner across to Google Hangouts. And if you could see my phone right now, if I can pull this up, I will. Let me switch to that account. And I'm going to show you my screen. So this is it on my mobile device. There's Google Hangouts, the mobile app, and there is the conversation that I had with Tom. He still hasn't answered me, so he's probably out to lunch. But there it is across all three. So it's on my mobile device. It is also in the Gmail app, or the Gmail, excuse me, the Gmail screen, down in the lower left-hand corner, integrated here, as well as the standalone Google Hangouts. I have one more question. If people have no more robocalls, will it go through? Okay, so the question's about, you know, a robocall blocker. Will it go through if it's anonymous or private caller? Yeah, so that's a potential issue that you may encounter, that it may come through and it may be blocked, or they might physically block it. It comes through as no caller ID or private or anonymous, and they might just choose to ignore it. And that's why it's good to set up a time to call the parent and say, I will call you at this time. Please be aware that my phone number might come through as no caller ID, or it might look like it's coming from New York or Boston. It's a good thing to try first. You know, call your cell phone from your computer and see what the number looks like as it's coming through, because that will kind of show you what it is. And that'll allow you to prepare the parent for it as well. So just maybe prompt them for what's about to happen, give them a set time when you're going to call, and then follow through at that point in time. And if it still doesn't work because they have some other robocall blocker set up, then you're going to have to stick to either Gmail communication or some other means that is going to get around that. Yeah, because it's possible that they could completely block you out altogether and it won't function. But give it a try. Try calling someone else. Try calling a spouse or a neighbor. Try calling your own cell phone. You'll kind of get an experience of what it looks like using the phone caller from Google Hangouts. And again, you might just simply want to use it as a quick chat, quick messaging type of service as well. So that is all of our time for today. I want to thank you for joining me for the Google Hangouts, Google Chat session, and I hope you tune in next time.